Thank you for joining us on Every Africa this morning. I'm Charity Chikene. This is the On Trend segment, where we take a look at stories making way across the social media. Well, the stories we're going to highlight today is a story of ODM, the Orange Democratic Movement, a political party here in Kenya that faced a somewhat botched election over the weekend. Another story we're going to make through our way is a story of Uganda. Now, Uganda's president, Yoweri Museveni, is still receiving a lot of international calls, and a lot of aid agencies are withdrawing their money from the Ugandan economy, citing the anti-gay laws that have been passed that are not in favor of human rights. Another story that is making way is the story of Lupita Nyong'o's statement when she said, no matter where you come from, your dreams are valid. So people are tweeting on the hashtag valid, just giving their views on what they feel is valid in their lives according to their own personalities. Another story making its way here in Kenya is the story of the matatu strike. Now, yesterday, the transport system in Kenya came to a standstill owing to matatu owners when they claimed the government of Nairobi, that is the Nairobi County, is taxing them too highly when it comes to parking fees. So let's get on with the stories now. Let's begin with the valid hashtag. So a lot of people are making known what they feel is valid in their life. Here we have this. My followers is a valid reason why all social media, that is Cameron Jones, this, my followers, is a valid reason why all social media should be scrapped, burned, forgotten, gone, outie, 5,000. So just people are making their way. Some are making sense, some are not making sense. But basically, at the end of it all, people are coming in to just give out what they feel is valid in their life. We have here, biased is still a valid option. That is Courtney Taylor 2. Let's move on. Another valid question is, where do these stupid pictures come from? Like, what does someone gain by starting this rumor stroke scam? So just people are making way. Just some of them don't make sense. Others do make sense. Like this one over here, we have this little small car here, and we have Kenyan Facts saying, photo of the day, no matter where you stand, your dreams are valid. So you can get this particular Range Rover if you dream big and if you work hard. So this is particularly a hashtag that you should follow to ensure that your dreams become part of what the world understands. You can share your vision, share your views so that the whole world may know the hashtag is valid. Moving on to another hashtag making way here in Kenya is the ODM story. Now, ODM had a botched election over the weekend, and they spent a tune of 32 million Kenyan shillings in this particular election. One photo I'd like to highlight for you is this particular photo, Men in Black starring Orange Democratic Movement. People are making fun of this particular election. We have people who are dressed in black, they're supposed to provide security, but later the other people responsible for trashing the particular elections, citing that the election itself was fraud. So people are making genius pictures and comments when it comes to this particular story. We have here the governor of Nairobi, that is Evans Kidero. I cannot seem to open it, so the camera will zoom in for you. Just talking to you in regards to the matatu strike that happened here in Kenya. So basically, people aren't happy in the political scene we have here. So let me just tune that particular photo to the matatu hashtag. So here we are. As far as I can see, that is Lydia Karaoke, who's saying, as far as I can see, matatus are back to work. Or is it the claim before, is it, or is it, beg your pardon, the calm before the storm? We have here the Shinsky, who's saying, unknown elements of the matatu association here planned and executed the matatu strike, jana, meaning Swahili for yesterday. And what is the MOA, that is the Matatu Association job then? If Kama and Askaris can do that. Kama is the city council and Askaris are the police. So basically, just to give you the reinforcements that were yesterday in town, riot police came to the Nairobi CBD to actually remove taxis that were blockading the Nairobi central business districts, just in protest over what they called a government shutdown of operations in the transport system. Another story making way. If you just take a look at this whole particular wall, just to get information on what you need to know about the Matatu strike yesterday. High school got talent. We have here Matatu strike. Is it the realization that is useless to cause the strikes that can help us complete a global stage? So just to give you that information coming in right there. So a lot of people are making their voices heard, their comments heard on this particular tweet. If you're being affected by the Matatu strike, this is a tweet for you to be able to send out your disregard for what the government is doing in Kenya. And you can actually sell your social frustration when it comes to the Nairobi County. So take a look at this particular wall. It is quite interesting what you may find and what you might read. Now, another story coming in is a story of Uganda. Now, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni signed the anti-gay bill into law last week. So a lot of people are are taking back their pledges to the Ugandan economy. The latest country to remove their pledge to Uganda is Sweden. Now, they removed the money off the budget of Uganda, citing that this particular law is against human rights and they will not be associated with what Uganda has to offer. Another thing coming out of Uganda is President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has given the shoot to kill order when it comes to poachers in his country. Indeed, we had marked the World Wildlife Day on Monday. It was a universal celebration. So people are coming out together championing conservation in not only Kenya, Africa, but the world over. So people are being told that poaching is against the law and Uganda is taking a stance with a shoot to kill order. So this is just what is happening in this particular wall. You can have your say on what you think Uganda is going through. Finally, let's finalize with matters Ebru Africa. Now, Ebru Africa is the page to be at when it comes to Facebook. We give you the latest information making way across the Kenyan scene, African scene, and the globe over. I'm Charity Chikene. This was The On Trend.